Hi everyone! Today I'm going to show you how to make these four easy hair accessories that you can make for any of your stuffed animals. Now let's get started! The first one I'm going to show you is called the twist headband, and you need kind of a stretchy t-shirt material. I just have a long rectangle of this, and the first thing I'm going to do is just fold it in half. You can't really tell with this fabric, but you want the good side facing in, because we're going to turn this inside out. And I'm just going to pin this down and sew a zigzag stitch all along the bottom, and that is so that the material can still stretch. Now we're going to turn it inside out. Once you're done with that, you're going to want to lay it flat with the seam side actually facing up, and you'll want it lined up right in the middle. So the next thing you need to do is just to flip that over, and then we're just going to fold it in half. And what you want to do now is align the bottom of this top strip right with the middle of the bottom piece. So as you can see here, the bottom of that top strip should be aligned with the seam of the bottom strip. Now you're just going to kind of fold over the extra parts sticking out. So that's what I'm doing here. And now you have all these folds, which we're going to want to sew together. I'm going to do a little curve right there using the straight stitch. Once that's done, I'm going to trim off the extra, and then you can turn it inside out and you have this beautiful twist right in the front. So I'm going to put this on a Build-A-Bear, but you can make this for any size stuffed animal. And there you go. Now we're going to move on to the bow headband. Materials you'll need for this one are pins, scissors, fabric, and your elastic. Here are the measurements I used, and I made this for a Build-A-Bear. Now the first thing we're going to do is take our large rectangle fabric and fold it in half, good side to good side. And I'm just going to pin right along the bottom, and then I'm going to do a straight stitch there. When I'm done, I'm just going to turn it inside out, and then we'll move on to our smaller rectangle. I'm just going to fold it good side to good side and then pin along the bottom like I did for the last one. And then we're just going to do a straight stitch right along the bottom. Now we're going to turn this inside out. Now we can feed our elastic through. I always put a safety pin at the end of my elastic, so it's just easier to move through the cloth. And I'm making sure to pin down the ends. And once I get this through, I'm going to pin down the other side so we can just set this aside. When that's done, we can go back to our big rectangle piece, and I'm just finding the midpoint. So that's where I'm going to fold the fabric little by little to make like the pinched center of a bow. And I'm just going in with a needle and thread to hold it together. So I'm just going back and forth a few times. And then I'll just lock my stitch and we can move on. Now I'm going to take that little square piece and I'm just going to fold it in on itself a few times until it kind of becomes a thin strip with no raw edges. So now I'm going to place this right in the middle of the bow. And I'm going to wrap it around and pin it in the back, and then I'll just do a straight stitch right there to close it. When that's done, I'm going to trim off the excess, and I actually put it on inside out so I could turn it inside out and hide the seam, but a lot of work, so next time I would not put it on inside out. When that's done, we can attach our elastic. So I'm going to take out the pins and I'm going to lay one side right in the middle of our bow, and I'm going to fold the top and the bottom over it, closing it like this, and I'm just going to pin that in place and repeat on the other side. And then when both of them are secured, I'm just going to do a straight stitch on each of those little folds. When that's done, you can turn it inside out and your headband is done. I'm going to put this on a Build-A-Bear, but because of the elastic, it can actually fit a lot of different sized heads. And I know this doesn't really match her outfit right now, but I just wanted to show you how it fits. And there you are. That's how to make a bow headband. The next thing we're going to make is a simple bow, and all you'll need are these two rectangles of fabric. So first I'm going to fold this in half. When it's folded in half, the dimensions of this rectangle are about 4 inches by 3 inches, but if you want to recreate this, you can do any rectangle proportional to 4 inches by 3 inches. Now I'm actually going to refold this so that it's good side to good side, and I'm going to pin right around the edges. And we're eventually going to do a straight stitch all the way around. You don't have to leave a space for turning inside out. We're actually going to cut right in the middle later. When that's done, I'm just going to trim the corners so that they come out really easily. And now I'm going to make a vertical cut right in the middle of the rectangle. So I'm just pinching the inside a little bit so I can make the little cut. And then I'll use that opening to turn the whole thing inside out. You'll want to make sure the corners are all the way out, so I used a pencil to get those poked out. When that's done, we can start pinching the center of our bow, and you'll want to make sure it hides the little cut we made. Once everything is pinched, I'm just going to pin it so it stays in place. Now I'm just going to take that thin rectangle fabric and fold in the sides like this so the raw edges are closed. And now I'm just going to wrap it around the center of our bow, and I'm going to just sew a straight stitch along the back. When that's done, I'm just going to trim off the excess, and you can add your bobby pin, which is what I usually do, so you can put it on any stuffed animal's ear. The last thing I'm going to show you is how to make a bow, but without any sewing necessary, so no sewing machine at all. Here I have a rectangle fabric that's about 7 by 4 inches, and like the last one, any similar dimensions will work. And I'm just going to turn this over and fold in the insides a little bit like this. Then I'm just going to fold over the top side and the bottom in towards the center like this. Now that all our raw edges are covered, we can start pinching the middle like we did for the last bow. And as you can see, this one's a little bit more crisp looking than the last bow, so just depends on what look you want. And I'm just going to now take some thread and I'm going to tightly wrap this around the center. When you're done, you can set this aside, and you could actually leave it like this and maybe put a jewel in the center if you want, but for me, I'm going to take a thin piece of fabric and fold in the insides like this, and then I'm just going to wrap it around the center of the bow. And to secure it in the back, you can use any kind of glue you want. You could sew it by hand if you want, or you could even use a clip or a safety pin if you don't want to secure it permanently. Before you close it up though, if you don't want to use a bobby pin to put it on the stuffed animal, you can also add a little yarn right in the middle before you close it up. And that way you can just tie it onto anyone's ear or even their head. And I just hot glued mine and I'm just going to trim it off. Then I'm just going to add a bobby pin to mine. And once you do that, your bow is done. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you next time. Bye!